Do you have a paranormal encounter you'd like to share with us? Send us an email with your story for a chance of it being featured on Weird World. Security guards, especially night shift workers, are often in the front line of experiencing mysterious and even terrifying paranormal occurrences. Here are four recent accounts of chilling entities haunting around these guards' work sites. Gary used to work graveyard shift at a tomato plant between two towns in the Central Valley in California. The area was quite remote, with only a few houses spread out and interspersed with dairies and open spaces. There was literally no one around in the area at all, and in his 5 years in the job, Gary never saw anyone walking outside there. He would watch Netflix or listen to podcasts between rounds, based in a guard shack behind which there was an open field. One night, at about 2:30 to 3 a.m., Gary stepped outside to smoke and was watching something on his phone when he heard talking and laughing coming from behind the guard shack. After dismissing the sound as just the wind or voices carrying from the nearby dairy, he kept hearing the laughing and giggling, so he decided to peek around the side of the shack. Gary explains that he grew up in a ghetto and then joined the military, so it takes quite a bit to scare him. Looking around the side of the small building, he saw only the open field, but strangely continued to hear the giggling. He took a couple of more steps and was shocked by what he saw. Two small children were standing in the middle of the field, talking and giggling with each other. They appeared to be a little boy and a little girl, around the ages of 7 to 10 years. Wondering how the children had got there, he squinted his eyes to check that he wasn't seeing things. These few seconds felt like an eternity, as in disbelief, Gary observed that the children were almost see-through, and their clothes looked antiquated, like early 20th or late 19th century attire. He then noticed that they appeared to have a body only from the waist up, as he couldn't see their legs. Just then, the children became quiet and turned to look in his direction, as if they had just realized that he was watching them. When they did that, he saw that they had no eyes, just dark holes where their eyes were supposed to be. Gary felt a cold feeling of terror in his bones and threw down his cigarette, then switched on all the lights and closed all the blinds in the guard shack. The front blinds to look outside had never been closed the whole time he had worked there. Almost shaking, he felt an uneasy dread, said a quick prayer, and tried to call his wife. It was only halfway through his shift, but he didn't do any more rounds until the sun came out. He has since learned that black-eyed children are a known paranormal phenomenon, and that usually, at their worst, will ask for access to whatever car or building you are in. The idea is to not allow them in, as they aren't physically forceful but need permission. It's probably scary enough that their presence fills you with fear and dread, as Gary experienced. Connor works third shift security at a brewery and reports that during his first week of working there, something just felt off. He dismissed the feeling as caused by being in a new work environment and now working alone at night. There are two main buildings in the same complex, the brewery and the bar about 200 feet away, which is where the third shift guards tend to stay around at night, as it has a good overview of the facility. The lights are movement activated and automatically turn off and on with motion. One night, Connor was returning from a patrol around the facility and walked into the bar area as he normally would. As expected, the light switched on after he took a few steps inside, but then he froze. In the doorway, going into the back room, there stood a bizarre creature, which he describes as humanoid, but not quite. Its arms were much too long, and its hair covered most of its upper body. He observed that the doorway was almost too narrow for it to get through. After a few seconds of witnessing this strange being, Connor blinked and it was gone. He later found out that he is not the only one who's seen it. After asking around amongst his colleagues, he found that a few of the day shift workers do seem to know what he's talking about, but most refuse to discuss the apparition. Over the next few weeks, he experienced several more encounters with the creature, but only in the bar. He reached the conclusion that the spectral entity couldn't leave the location. Connor explains that one of the main public sections inside the brewery has a set of two doors, outside and inside doors, which work like a kind of airlock. When a worker scans their access card after hours, the doors will automatically open, then close after about 30 seconds. However, the outside door has a tendency to get stuck. On one occasion, Connor was standing in that airlock space, looking outside and waiting for the doors to close. The inside door closed first behind him, and then the outside door closed. Appallingly, as it did, he saw in the glass reflection the spectral creature standing right behind him. Terrifyingly, it was towering over him and staring down, its long arms hanging at its side. Connor decided there and then that he would no longer stand in that space while waiting for the doors to close. He goes inside, switches the lights on, then turns around and waits for the door to close. Paul used to work as an outside patrol driver for a research and development company. His job involved driving around the large industrial complex in a small patrol car. In doing so, he experienced several weird occurrences and heard even more secondhand from co-workers. Most of the buildings in the complex were relatively new, but there was an old brick mill building which had been constructed back in the early days of the Industrial Revolution. Paul speculated that there had been considerable suffering and fatalities in that building back in the day. The company employed a dedicated interior patrol guard, but when he was busy, Paul would sometimes be sent to activated alarms inside the building. One night, at around 2 a.m, he was sent to a motion sensor alarm in the old mill building. He walked around the area for a few minutes until he finally found the source of the alarm, which turned out to be a dead sensor. He became more than a little freaked when he picked up some disturbance as he was leaving. His flashlight kept turning off, not defunct, but switching off every few seconds. He swiftly left the area, but swears he heard footsteps behind him. The dedicated interior patrol guard, who had worked in the complex since the early 2000s, told Paul a lot of stories about the various eerie phenomena there. He claimed that every so often in that old mill building, he would hear a voice and see shadows moving. He also described seeing, twice, a man wearing a dark suit and a top hat, standing facing out of the windows overlooking the river. The man never responds when spoken to, and also never seems to move from that spot. Witnesses say that if you blink or look away for even a fraction of a second, he will have disappeared when you look back. A lot of workers in the building were quite fearful of seeing this apparition. Keith used to work as a security guard at a nuclear power plant, on usually afternoon and evening shifts. The guards would access the alarms in one building where, on checking the printer for the alarm, a badge number would be shown. However, strange things were happening. There would be no badge number, or they would be notified of a door alarm triggered by someone exiting without using their card. A check of the printer would indicate that no one had been in the building for an hour, and someone unknown had exited. The guards referred to the ghost as Norman because there was a handed-down narrative about a construction worker having perished in an accident in the area of that particular building just before the plant went online. The staff eventually found out that the rumours were a true story. A worker named Norman had been killed in an accident in that area. Perhaps he was still coming and going, resulting in the alarms being triggered.